हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम अगेन। टुडेज सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द एक्सटर्नल बॉडी पार्ट्स ऑफ गोट। ऑब्जेक्टिव्स आर सेम विच इज स्टडी प्रीवियसली, लाइक टू बी एक्वाइंट एंड डिस्टिंग द स्पेसिस, ब्रीड एंड इंडिविजुअल्स, फेनोटाइप ऑफ कै गोट, to find out external abnormalities and to know the usefulness and functions of each part. The study of body parts help in identifying the individual phenotype and also in carrying out the scientific studies related to growth and development of the animals. And the study also helps in the assessing defective body parts, if any, judging of dairy animals and draft purpose animals require a thorough knowledge about the body parts. Placement of differentiating character is easy when the person knows the body parts. And precautions are to be taken, just like be careful and cautious while approaching the animal. Do not forget to win it confidence. Carefully restrain the animals in travis or crate. Do not excite the animal. Be aware of the vices and handles animals carefully. Material required for this exercise like live specimen, rope, travis, crate, cakes, feed and fodder, pegs, photograph, charts, model of cattle, a species like sheep or goat instead of live specimen if not available. In procedure, carefully put the goat in travis or crate, secure the animal against pole or support and stabilize animal by providing green fodder. The body part of ruminant generally has four regions like cattle's. First one is head, second one is neck, body and quarters. First we will see the head region. This is one of the important region which is helps to differentiate the breeds from each other, and the functions and location of different parts of the head region are as unders, included horns. They are in pair and situated on the head, and the functions of horns are self-defense, age estimation and graceful appearance, as well as breed characteristics. Second one is head crest. It is a line joining the roots of the horns, and the raised portion of the crest is called as pole or nimbori, and it is prominent in exotic breeds as compared to indigenous breed. Next one is face. This is portion between the crest of head and opening of the mouth and its following subparts. Forehead. The portion between the line of head crest and line of two eyes is called as forehead. Next one is nostrils. This includes the central bridge starting from center of the line, joining two eyes and elongated up to the muzzle. Nostril are the two opening at the lower end of the nose, and respiration is the main function of the nostrils. Next one is muzzle. This is black portion with the grayish spot above the upper lip, and muzzle indicates the general health condition. During sound health, it is moist, and while it is dry during sickness. Next one is mouth. It is opening of intake of food and water. It indicates upper jaw, lower jaw, tongue, tip and dental pad, called as upper jaw. Next one is eyes. Eyes are situated on each side of the nose bridge and comprises of eyebrow, eyelashes, eyelids and eyeball. Appearance may be defined as bright, dull and sleepy. Next one is ears. Ears are located on both the side of the horns. Next one is neck portion. This is second portion of the animal body. This is portion between head and body, includes neck crest. It is lying between center of the pole to the hump, and this line is supported with heavy muscular growth. Next one is body. This portion is situated between hump and sacrum, included following subparts like back, The portion situated between hump and sacrum supported by ribs called as back include chine. It is a portion just behind the hump and up to the point where last two ribs meet. Next one is loin, a triangular portion between chine and sacrum called as loin. Then hollow of the flank, triangular depression just below the loin on both sides called as hollow of the flank, where the respiration rate of the animal can be checked. Then hip bone, the raised bone of hollow of the flank is termed as hip bone, and they are two in number situated on both the sides. The distance between two bones indicate the development of the reproductive organs in female. Next one is chest, bottom portion of body covered by ribs called as chest, and heart or chest gives the circumference of the chest measured at the point of meter. Next one is abdomen, the ventral portion of the body region uncovered by the ribs called as abdomen, and it consists of navel flap and navel point, a fold of skin hanging in between the chest and udder or scrotum is called as navel flap. Fourth region, that is limbs or quarter, includes forequarter and hindquarters. Forequarters, this region is an important in selecting the animal for draft purpose. Included hump and shoulder, shoulder blade, arms, forearm, knee joint, shank, patcher, fetlock, cornet and hoof, and last one is dew claws. Shoulder uppermost portion of the front legs called as shoulder. Next one is shoulder blade, flat triangular bones of the shoulder known as shoulder blade. Next one is arms, this is a portion of legs in between shoulder and point of elbow known as arms. The next one is forearm or elbow. This is joint between forearm and shank. Forearm, the portion in between point of elbow and knee joint. Knee joint, this is joint between forearm and shank. Next one is shank, this is the portion between knee and pastern. Last one is pastern, portion between shank and fetlock called as pastern. Then fetlock, the portion between patcher and cornet known as fetlock. Cornet, the portion covered with the hair just above the hoof called as cornet. Then hooves or dew claws, lowermost hard portion of the legs is called as hoof, and there are two digits of the hoof. The gap between the digit is termed as interdigital space. The hardback portion is heel, front portion is toe, and lowermost flat portion is called as sole. The hard finger like projection on back side of the pastern called as dew claws. Then hindquarters, the region provides the information on the development of reproductive organs, mammary glands, hence it has an important role in selection of the dairy animals. Includes sacrum, it is a portion extending from the loin to the tail root. Then rump, it is a slopy portion located below the sacrum called as rump. Then pin bone, the two projections on each side of the anus called as pin bone. Next one is thigh, the thick and fleshy portion of hind legs in between rump and hock bone, generally used for putting identification marks in branding method. Last one is tail, it is long whip-like structure in continuous of vertebral column called as tail. Then milk vein, a prominent zigzag veins starting from heart to the udder called as milk vein. And the veins get curved and bulged at the heart region with the depression is called as milk veins. Then milk mirror, a portion situated in between falva and rear udder called as milk mirror, and its wider size indicates the capacious udder, indicating the high milk production capacity in the cattle. Then udder and teats, also known as mammary gland, and the complete udder has forequarter which is absent in the goat, having only two teats. Front sorry. Next one is vagina and vulva. The outermost portion of female genital organ, triangular in shape and situated below the anus, called as vulva or vagina. It has an opening with two vulval lips and it is common passage for urination and mating purpose. Then scrotum and sheath. In case of male, scrotum, a male genital organ which is pouch-like structure in between the two hind legs, which is accommodates testicle and regulates the temperature for sperm production, called as scrotum. And sheath, it is a skin flap which covers penis and attached to the body, which is extended up to navel flap, and it protects the penis from the external injury, called as sheath in case of male. This is about the body parts of goat. So thank you.